In this video, I want to go over how to create a dream journal. Now, some of the reasons why you'd want to create a dream journal is so that obviously you can go back and look at your dreams and have a record of them, and so that you don't forget them. When I was younger, around about before I was 18, I actually could remember pretty much, not all, but a large amount of dreams I had when I was a child. I could remember them just in my mind, and they were all kind of there in my mind. But over the years after I was kind of 18 and a little bit beyond, I kind of forgot them all. And I can remember like quite a few of them, but I know I've definitely forgot a large corpus of dreams that I had as a child. And that's kind of sad. And I'm going to go back and try to recover them through, memory techniques. And I'm going to try to rediscover those dreams in my memories if I can. But that's for another video. But basically, what I'm saying is you don't want to lose the dream history that you have. You want to record them because dreams are a vital part of your thought, of your life, just like your conscious journal or diary. Dreams are like a journal or diary of your unconscious. And they can also really help you if you capture dream series, so not just one or two dreams, but multiple dreams over the years. You can then see different themes and patterns in your dreams through looking back at your journal, and you can pull out therapeutic ideas and things from them that really help you in your life. That's why you want to do a dream journal, is because ultimately it should have some benefit or help for you. If you don't find it interesting at all, then you probably wouldn't even click on this video, but it's something that I find very interesting. I've got a dream journal that goes back to 2011. Like I said, I was always a dreamer. I dreamed my entire life, and I can remember dreams before that. I should actually write them down before, just in case I forget them. But the ones I've written down are since 2011. So that's many, many years. And basically, some years I would dream way more than others. But now I'm getting back into it again and trying to make sure I record my dreams every time I wake up and have a dream. Okay, so the first thing I guess you'd do is record your dream straight away. Don't just wait. Don't wait, even 5 minutes or 2 minutes even, or don't even talk to someone or anything. You have to record your dream straight away, because dreams are just like poof, and then they'll just disappear. You really have to just, what I do is I wake up and just grab my phone straight like this. I go to my notes or whatever other application, if you have Evernote or some other note taking app that you record your notes on. Then I go to my notes and I just type, I open a new note and I type in dream, and then I just type my dream out just like that, right? And that's it. And the good thing about that is then this is really good, because you can then go back and type in dream, and then it's just got a collection of all your dreams there tagged with the word dream in it. That's why I put dream first. I write dream, and then I just write down exactly what happened in the dream in chronological order if I can. And then the good thing about this search function is you can look back later for analysis. So I can write in my friend's name. My friend's name is Reddy, and then it brings up all the dreams that my friend was in with his name all over the years. So dating back all the way to 2013, I've had dreams about my friend, and throughout all the years, 2016, 18, 15, 14, he's in my dreams, and I can look back and see, what does Reddy mean in my unconscious? Maybe the dream is about him, or maybe the dream is about my friendship with him, or maybe the dream is just using him as a symbol, and it's not just my friends. You can do that with any symbol or any word. I could go back and type in God and look through all the dreams that featured the word God in it. And so you've really got a very strong categorization system if you type it into your phone, as opposed to just writing it down by hand. Plus, it could be early in the morning and it might be dark, and that might hinder you from writing or writing something down. So I suggest highly to type it into your phone. I also would say don't record it with a voice recorder. I know that sounds easier than typing it into your phone, but the thing is that you will become too lazy to go back and transcribe that voice recording system, and you can't use the search functionality to search through your voice recordings. So honestly, the best thing I think is grab your phone, go to your notes, just write dream, and then just write your dream. That's it. Okay, pretty simple stuff. That's what I recommend, all right? And don't wait to do it. Do it straight away, otherwise you'll forget. And another thing is tell yourself before you go to bed, if I have a dream, as soon as I wake up, I'm going to grab my phone and record it. Just tell yourself that, because if you don't have that in your mind, you'll wake up and say, you'll feel resistance because you're tired and you're angry in the morning. Well, I know I am. I wake up and I'm like, I don't want to do anything. But if I wake up and that's just in my mind, oh yeah, I got to do that, then I just do it, okay? But if you just half-ass, kind of like you're not aiming it, trying to actually create a dream journal, you're going to wake up and you won't be bothered because you have the dream and you'll think that dream means nothing. Honestly, your conscious mind, when it wakes up, thinks that the dream is worthless. You've got to write it down and then later on appreciate what the dream is for itself. Okay, so basically respect the process and just commit to doing it, basically is what I'm saying. And another thing is try to actually get good sleep, because I don't know if it's with other people, but for me, when I only have like half a night's sleep, or my sleep's interrupted, or I'm only getting a short amount of sleep, I don't really dream. I don't go through, because you have to go through the full cycles. And normally you have the dream kind of the end of a cycle when you're in that lighter sleep. And you know, I used to have 3 to 5 dreams every night, because you go through about five dream cycles a night. And so I think it's about 90 minute cycles is a dream cycle. And so basically get good sleep, all right? And the way you do that, I'm going to try this again because it has worked for me in the past, is you can eat kiwi fruit about 30 minutes or an hour before you go to bed. Kiwi fruit's going to help and boost your melatonin production, which is going to help you have a more efficient and better sleep. So just try the kiwi fruits. You might have to have 1 or 2 every night for a month. If you do that, for me personally, I can see it working after a few days. But some, you know, the study they did actually was a month. So try it for a month, see if that does help your sleep, if you're having trouble with, having dreams and stuff like that. A note to point is dreams have been associated with certain kind of personalities, like people who are more creative and open temperamentally in the personality aspect are actually more prone to having dreams. So some people just dream less than others, but if you commit to wanting to record your dreams, there's something about that process of going, I'm going to record my dreams, and then going to sleep and waking up and then recording it straight away. There's something about that process that makes you dream more. I don't know why, but it kind of induces or encourages you to dream more, or you're just remembering your dreams more because you're focusing on remembering them more. One or the two, something like that, okay? I also heard, you know, folklore that it could be true that that B vitamins help you have more vivid dreams, so it can't hurt. Smash down some bananas, smash down some B vitamins. A lot of people are pretty deficient in B vitamins anyway, and they give you energy. So yeah, give that a try if you know, you never know. Just give it a try, see what happens. All right, so the main point is to record your dreams, respect the process, enjoy the process, and don't just think your dreams don't mean anything, because a lot of the time you can go back and you'll see, oh wait, that dream had a good point. It was kind of just pointing out, you know, this little bit of my life, but I didn't notice it at the time. And so, I've got a lot of other videos on Carl Jung, and specifically on Jung's rules for dream interpretation. And I'm going to continue to make other videos about dream interpretation, maybe with some of my friends. We can do a live dream interpretation with some fresh dreams that we've just had. So I'll be doing that. I'll be making more videos on Carl Jung and psychology and other random things. So if you like this video, then please subscribe and leave some comments in the comment section of the dreams you've had, share your experiences, and I'll see you in the next video.